Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe.
Obama likely furious after Ninth Circuit sides with Trump. Barack's legacy destroyed after scoring major win on sanctuary cities. Elder Patriot opinion. President Trump's attempt to restore order to sanctuary cities scored a major win yesterday in the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. By a 2-1 margin, the court ruled that he could allocate federal funds based on compliance with the DOJ's Community-Oriented Policing Services program. The Hill. The Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals on Friday ruled in favor of the Trump administration's efforts to prioritize federal dollars for local policing to towns and cities that have complied with certain immigration police policies. The ruling, a split 2-1 decision, said the Department of Justice was within its rights to withhold community-oriented policing services, grants from sanctuary cities, and states over their refusal to work with federal immigration enforcement authorities, and instead prioritize agencies that focused on unauthorized immigration and agreed to give immigration and customs enforcement access to jail records and immigrants in custody. The city of Los Angeles first sued the administration after it was denied a $3 million grant on the grounds that it did not receive the money because it did not focus on immigration for its community policing grant application. The decision reversed a district court's ruling. The panel rejected Los Angeles's argument that DOJ's practice of giving additional consideration to applicants that chose to further the two specified federal goals violated the Constitution's spending clause, wrote Judge Sandra Ikuta, joined by Judge J. Bybee. The panel held that DOJ did not exceed its statutory authority in awarding bonus points to applicants that selected the illegal immigration focus area or that agreed to certification, she wrote. This ruling has the potential to eradicate Obama's sanctuary legacy, and the most satisfying aspect of this is that President Trump is flipping the script on Obama and his surveillance state. Even if the Democrat media refuses to report it as such, Donald Trump scored big yesterday. Not just with the decision, but because he's obviously realized that potential of the massive database of personal data that Barack Obama has built. I am hereby ordering every department and agency in the federal government to provide the Department of Commerce with all requested records regarding the number of citizens and non-citizens in our country. They must furnish all legally accessible records in their possession immediately. We will utilize these vast federal databases to gain a full, complete, and accurate count of the non-citizen population. We will leave no stone unturned. Recall Maxine Waters running her big mouth in February of 2013 at the beginning of Obama's second term? Waters, the president has put in place an organization that contains the kind of database that no one has ever seen before in life. That's going to be very, very powerful. And that database will have information about everything on every individual in ways that it's never been done before. That's right. No more corrupt leftist ideological census takers filing false claims of citizenship. Investigate journalist Paul Sperry took a deep dive into the nefarious ways that Obama intended to use all of the data to remake America in his image. Now, President Trump has all of that information at his disposal, and he can use it for the good of American taxpayers. It's important to keep in mind that not everyone in sanctuary cities support the official policies they're being forced to live under. In a very real sense, they can be called hostages. That's especially so in cities where voter fraud decides their elections. This is the conclusion of an editorial that appeared in the New York Post, the daily within the city's third largest circulation. Bottom line, sanctuary policies are bad and protect no one other than those who have disrespected our country and already intentionally violated our laws. Schadenfreude.
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.